Hello, everyone. The by-election nomination is completed. It's a confirmed four-corner fight. 大家好，已经我们确认这次是四角战。我现在要来谈谈一下子就是多角的问题，multi-corner fight election. We look at the perspective in this way. Singapore has moved from the era of PAP automatic win on nomination day. 以前的时代，人民行动党在提名日自动当选的那种历史已经距离我们现在非常的遥远。现在他们呢，即使要获得 50% 的选票过半都已经很难。 It's very difficult for the famiLEE regime to even get past 50% point right now, because since the presidential elections onwards, they have been history. So we have to take into the right perspective to view our multi-corner political contest elections from now on. What does it mean? 我们要看一下我们这个 多角战应该如何对待？从现在开始呢，不出现多角战的选举是几乎不可能，就是说一个87席的选举里面，会出现多角战的选举，恐怕会超过一半。从现在，这个就是新加坡的一种成长过程，也就是很难再把对抗李家王朝的各个政党，包括独立人士的数目减少到就是只剩下一对一去投选。这种情形，当然呢，就会造成对李家王朝不满的那些选票不能够被集中在同一个有效的地方发挥。All the protesting votes, discontent, the people who wish not to vote for famiLEE regime now don't have a one single ballot choice to concentrate on. So this is a disadvantage from now on. But then we have to begin to learn how to deal with it from now on. Today, the issue is, I'm going to use a very shocking title. It will be the sex scandal of Lee Hsien Loong Ho Ching. 今天呢，我要把这个课题强调在李显龙和金性丑闻。为什么用这个性丑闻？因为现在新加坡的新闻，在法庭的新闻里面全部都是性丑闻。这一次的补选也是因为性丑闻，Michael Farmer 的婚外情it's come from the extramarital affair of Michael Farmer, the ex-parliament speaker, which led to this current by-election. It's got something to do with sex scandals. And you look at the professor and the students who are now registrars of court. 现在是法官的法律系学生跟他们的教授、讲师有这个性丑闻。现在黄文义、吴文杰、徐秀兰、those sex scandal cases involving the ex CNB and ex SCDF chiefs. All these are going on. And of course, we don't forget there's an extramarital affair which led to the previous by-election in Hougang, which involved my friend, Mr. Yao Xin Long. So these are to be looked together. Why are we missing some important points in the public opinion right now in the view of the sex scandals? It is the utmost important concern that it conflicts with the public interest when somebody's duty is compromised. Somebody's duty to guard public interest is compromised. 当公众利益有牵涉到的公权力，从性关系，从各种各样的性关系里面，造成呢有不当的利益冲突，这就是公众需要注意。如果某人有婚外情 不影响公众的利益，这个是私人事情，就是说私事竟并非国事。 It's not a national matter if it does not have any concern, connection affecting the interest of public. No public fund, money, decision chain have been affected. Then it's a private matter. But if it involves anything with involve the public interest, then this is a concern. This is a duty of the CPIB, 贪污调查局的职责的范围了。那我们 看为什么黄文义的 case， 举一个例子，黄文义的职责，他要决定国家的这个数独局的电脑contract 被那个合约被 award 给哪一家公司做，跟徐秀兰工作的公司有关系，这样子是否有不当的决定影响到，那么我们那些法律讲师。 这个教授，他们有权利决定什么学生可以考合格不合格的考试，谁可以当上律师、法官，这个就牵扯到公众的利益。他用不当的性关系，去影响错误的决定、不公正、不公平的决定，unjust decision, corrupted decisions made, in the capacity of professor, someone who have the power to pass, fail the gradings of the students and lead to public position appointment and be listed on the bar as a lawyer, a judge in Singapore. That concerns. And why I want to bring this attention to the public regarding the sexual relations within the family between Lee Hsien Loong and Ho Ching. Now, 为什么我要提到 李显龙、何晶的性关系，因为这两个人的权掌握在他们的手里，但是他们在床上肯定有关系，孩子都生了，有一张婚姻注册局的结婚证书是要分开看的，到底他们之间的关系，他们之间的性关系。 有没有影响他们两个人的公权力？一个人是总理，掌握新加坡内阁最高的权力；另一个人呢，是掌握新加坡老百姓最大笔的公众资产，政府投资公司、大马戏、GIC的钱。这个两个人的重要职权职务有很大、最大。 比黄文义，比这个法律教授的权力大太多倍了，影响我们太多，更多了。The power of a prime minister and the CEO of the massive holding, is too much compared to the power, of the director of CNB, chief of SCDF, the professor in the law faculty, in terms of the extent it affects the public interest. So we have no doubt they have sex relation in a marriage. How does it affect their decision? Are their decision compromised by their sexual relation, the family relation? This does the same thing. Only difference is a piece of paper from the ROM, which is called the Certificate of Marriage. 唯一的差别，他们有进行同样的对公众利益有影响的性关系，但是唯一差别合法化与不合法化的性关系，只差别在婚姻注册局的那一张结婚证书。那张纸并不能用来漂白。 性贿赂、贪污， the certificate of marriage cannot be something that legitimize and purify a corrupt decision. When there's a corrupt decision affecting public interest, it's the same offense. It's the same damage and intolerable moral crime that we have to see It cannot be legitimized by a piece of paper issued by the certificate, by the registry of a marriage. Let me go to the other extent. If you want to see Mr. Ng Boon Gay's case, that Cecilia, they have extramarital affair, and they are facing, Ng is facing charge in the court for sexual corruption charged by the CPIB. What if they want to legitimize it? Ng can divorce his wife and Cecilia can have a divorce, and they say, okay, this is my fiance and I'm registering my relationship with Cecilia and I'm a CNB chief. So what's the deal? That is the same as Lee Hsien Loong and Ho Ching. Then why I should face charge, and why Lee Hsien Loong and Ho Ching doesn't face charge? You got it now? You look at the president of France. You have a sex relationship with a model, a famous model, extramarital affair. Then he legitimizes it. The press and the public give him the pressure. He says, okay, I'm divorcing my wife and I'm marrying this model. So what? What is there to be scandalous about? He can purify it. He can launder his scandal. And Ng Boon Gay can do the same. The SCDF chief can do the same. The professor in the law faculty can say, oh yeah, I'm going to divorce my wife. I'm going to marry my student. So what? Yes, she's my student. So what? Then the CPIB cannot charge. So therefore, I'm highlighting to you, Lee Hsien Loong Ho Ching sex relation is a scandal. They have very important decision in the nation's biggest lump of wealth. That Ho Ching is a subordinate reporting directly or indirectly to the Prime Minister. It started from the day before Lee Hsien Loong was Deputy Prime Minister. When he was even the Finance Minister, they had a conflict of interest and they have a relationship in bed for sure. So how is that to be considered? This is something that I'm highlighting in this video for you to consider. 这就是我今天在这个视频里面直接关系到这次补选。 为什么Michael Farmer 造成这次的补选吗？ 是不是？ 就是 婚外情跟婚内情的唯一差别就是只有一张纸，就是结婚证书而已。那么老婆、老公是可以换的吗？法国的总统已经证明这一点吗？人家只知道他婚外情，他就换了老婆，他的小三情妇变成老婆，变成总统夫人。你们乖乖，贵宾在总统府门口要给他敬礼，外国的总统、外国的贵宾都要以总统夫人的礼节接待他吗？ 他不是小三了吗？差别在哪里？那一张纸，那一张纸能够漂白吗？能够把贪污影响公众利益，影响公正精神的行为，把它合法化吗？这就是这次补选的时候，大家应该在投票的时候也榜而东的选民应该考虑这个问题，就是考虑的我所讲的。 李显龙合金性丑闻，谢谢大家，Thank you。